I first became interested in bionics when I suffered frostbite to my biological legs in 1982. Now, I got frostbite from, I was out mountain climbing, but I wanted to jump back on the horse because I'm passionate about climbing. And the question was, how might this be possible? So what I did is I took an approach to getting back to the vertical world of just designing lots and lots of different gadgets. My closets were just filled with legs. I had some feet that would wedge into rock fissures where the human foot cannot even get into. I have feet that can penetrate ice and vertical ice wall. And I could, you know, with these feet, I could climb thousands of feet and never experience calf fatigue like my poor colleagues with biological legs. It's really sad. So through this technological advancement, I was actually able to climb better with artificial limbs than I achieved with normal biological limbs. In fact, I was the first person in history to go back to my chosen sport after losing a major part of my body. Oh, there we go. Great. Let's go forward now. So there you see the spike foot. So I was the first person to go back to elite levels in the sport after losing a major part of my body. And naturally, my climbing colleagues, some of them got really peeved and competitive with me. And one person actually said, I'm going to cut my legs off. And well, he, you know, turns out he never did amputate his legs. In fact, he was maybe a little uncertain about his claims of cheating.